Nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Pues siendo fiesta, la fiesta principal de Epifanía el día de hoy, y no el domingo, en el calendario tradicional, voy a decir unas palabras en inglés. Well, today we celebrate the feast of Epiphany, and it is just a good thing to bring to mind these words from St. Paul when he says, "All things work for the good of those who love God." So that means simply that all the events of providence, whether fortunate or unfortunate, everything that has to do with health, with wealth, with reputation, every condition of life, every temptation, every trial, even our own sins, work for the advantage of those who love God. In order for us to understand this, we only need to remember David, or St. Paul, or St. Peter, whose sins only served to make them more holy, more humble, and more grateful to God. At least this is what we learn from the Magi in the Gospel today. They saw the star and its rising, as the Gospel says, and they had no doubts. Their unbounded faith was strong and sure, so they didn't hesitate at the prospect of the trials of a long journey. They didn't postpone the journey, because their souls were ready. A star often appears in the heavens of our souls. That's what we call inspiration from God. Clear and intimate, urging us to greater generosity and calling us to a life of closer union with Him. So, contemplating these three kings, we understand at least one thing, that everyone who seeks God finds Him, no matter what. So we should follow their example and their perseverance, even when we seem to be in darkness. And this same newborn king that the Magi wanted to see is the same one we find hidden in the Blessed Sacrament, hidden behind the appearances of bread, waiting for those who love Him to find Him and to adore Him. That is why on this feast of the Epiphany, it would be a great thing for us to evaluate the time that we take, the effort that we make to prepare ourselves to receive Him in Holy Communion. Because that is exactly what we do. Once we acknowledge Him present on the altar, as St. José María Escriba calls Him, the Bethlehem of the altar, once we find Him and acknowledge His presence, the first thing we do is to kneel down, to adore Him. So as we prepare ourselves to receive Him in Holy Communion, let us take the time to prepare a warm welcome in our soul today. Muy bien.